Dutch Sense here. 1:43 a.m. Central Time on Monday, April 30th, 2012. And we're looking at in telecast here, and I'm going to go ahead and show you a few things that are going on our radar frequency-wise, and we're going to issue a forecast for the next 24 to 48 hours, possibly up to 72, for severe weather in the areas that are experiencing the flash anomalies. So let's just start off right off the bat. There's a few things occurring in the storm itself that I'd like to point out to you first of all. And we'll just go ahead and pause this up and bring it forward frame by frame. Now you'll see several unnatural looking edges in the storm here. These are the edges of the frequency spike areas that are spiking into the high RF. Now it's only showing on radar for a slight time, and these are not natural signals. So they're emanating from ground-based stations. And I'm going to hit play here and you can watch it go forward. And the square edge on this is what I call a scalar square, or it also could be called a rectangle wave. It's a type of geometric modulation that's done from the ground base station. It's done in conjunction with the other type of signatures. So normally you'll see a round signature like what you have out of here out of St. Louis emanated out in a series of concentric rings. Then you'll see a series of square edges appear when they up the amplitude. And of course, this is not a missing panel. This is fully illuminated. This is not a square in the sky. This is shown on the computer screen only. This is an algorithm transformation. The computer is seeing a wave go through the air and it's saying, aha, square wave. And it's showing it as that on the actual radar scope, the animated radar scope. Now you see these other intersecting lines and rings. What this means is everywhere where you see a ring, you need to watch the center of that ring area for up to 48 or 72 hours for damaging winds, hail, and possible tornadoes. So let's name some towns here, and we'll have to watch for 3 days now. So that would be down here in Texas. Let's just start in the southwest, just northwest of Wichita Falls, also coming up towards Oklahoma City, and we'll back this out so you can see the edge of the rings that I'm talking about here. Here's one here flashing on and off. You can see the concentric ring also coming out of southern Kansas, so we need to watch south central Kansas. Also going east, we need to watch Fort Smith, Arkansas. Also need to watch Topeka, Kansas, going eastward to St. Louis. And St. Louis has two phenomena going on here, not one. A hollow ring center and, of course, a ring epicenter going all the way around that we can trace back to St. Louis. Now, let's back it out one. And you'll see off to the east, we have a different type of flash ring anomaly. This is a giant flash ring. It doesn't look like your normal concentric rings here that are very organized. Instead, this flashes on like a background clutter. However, it's flashing quickly into the high RF. You'll notice part of it's actually even frozen. Now, I've saw one of these before. It appeared over Hopkinsville, Kentucky, and a tornado hit that area within 2 days. So we'll have to watch this area up here over New York and see if New York indeed does get hit. It looks like the track of the storm might indeed come that way. If not this storm, within 72 hours, the next storm off the west coast. Now furthermore, down here to the south, you can see in Georgia, going through West Virginia, down through Virginia, down into Georgia along the east coast, a series of flashes. Now this is a different kind of ring compared to the others. It's good that we get to see them all in conjunction with each other, so you guys can understand the difference in the different types of rings. So here's one with a very accentuated outer edge. Here's one down here to the south with concentric spirals. Here is a scalar square. Down here you can see the flat edge nature of this with a return on the inside, proving that it's not a missing panel. There's actually a return on the inside of the square. Now you just go north and here's an illuminated scalar square, which with the inside actually fully filled. Again, proving it's not a missing panel. And you come over here, you have background clutter rings that are showing up that look like this type of HAARP ring, but in a low frequency. So all in all, it's great to see it all in one shot so somebody can understand what's going on. However, it's bad to see it because this means additional severe weather will develop within 48 hours and hit these areas specifically. Everywhere where you see a gigantic frequency flash is an area we need to watch. Now, I'm going to show you guys something I put together on my main page. We'll go over to the weather monitoring links, and I've assembled all the .gov and .edu weather sites, as well as the private companies that handle this. So, for instance, we could go over and check AccuWeather, Now, they have been having a few problems with this AccuWeather map. It's been popping on and off. I guess they're probably working on it, maybe updating it. But this AccuWeather map the other night showed us a huge amount of frequency spikes that are now being hit currently. And to show you guys that, let me just open up one more window here. And I'll bring you down on the blog post to the frequency spike from 2 days ago. Okay, sorry, I've got a lot of blog posts here. It's been a busy couple days. And here we go. This is on the 28th. All right, look at these areas here. All right, so that goes from Texas into Oklahoma through southwest Missouri, going up into southwest Illinois, and furthermore over here to Kentucky. Now, here's a better shot of it. Again, 2 days ago. And then we come back over, we go to IntelliCast, and look at the areas that have already been hit or are being hit now, and they're roughly the same areas. Literally, the only areas that we've seen no activity yet has been right here. Now, this storm is eventually going to come to the northeast, and we will see activity down here in Arkansas, also in Kentucky and Tennessee. So that, to me, is a confirmation that, indeed, the frequency, high-frequency flashes are indeed connected to storm manipulation. Whether it's done purposefully, whether it's done by accident, I don't know. It looks like it's done in conjunction, in a pattern, synced up, which means that it's most likely not an accident. At this point, we could pretty much say that the storms that are hitting these centers of these rings over and over and over again are the result of a high-frequency flash, which induces storm activity within a few days. Now, another way I can show that to you, if you guys are skeptical about this, I've put together a whole post on what I'm describing and what I'm showing. I explain it fully, I provide video evidence, and most importantly, what I've provided as of January of this past year, January 28th this year, I put together this post with several, over a dozen forecast confirmation links, if not more, if you go down the sub list. We're talking dozens and dozens of my forecast confirmations where I come back in and show you guys 2 days after the HAARP ring what's actually occurred. And it's pretty much, I mean, I don't see how anybody can deny it. But here you go. If you are skeptical, go watch these and tell me, get back to me on what you think is causing, for instance, Key West, Florida. We see a ring appear out of Key West, Florida, and within 2 days, Key West, Florida is hit with a tornado. Or we see a ring out of a small town in the middle of nowhere, and that small town in the middle of nowhere gets hit within 2 days. And we name the town. That's the key, too, is to name the town so that there's no question if the town gets hit or not. You can come back and point to it and say, this spot got hit. Okay? Hang in there, folks. Much love. And also, really quick, I want to thank Julio as somebody who just interviewed me. I did a 3.5-hour radio interview that we're going to get out over the next day or two. And hopefully, it might take a little longer, but it's a great interview, and we fully discuss WeatherMod and all the aspects. So I want to thank Julio for that, and just watch out for that in the next couple days. And it's truly an eye-opener. I hope you guys enjoy it. Cheers.